Hello everyone, myself Professor Rahul Kumar Sen. Now today I am going to teach topic of trusses, and this topic is very interesting topic, and this topic is related to our subject engineering mechanics. Now, as we know that we already discussed in few previous lecture or classes where we discuss mechanics and engineering mechanics. Now if we just talk about concepts of engineering mechanics, so engineering mechanics is the branch of applied physics which deal with the study of forces, movement and their fundamental application. Engineering mechanics may be categorized in two forms, static mechanics and dynamic mechanics. Now, the topic we are going to study here, trusses, is totally related to our static mechanics. So, now this is our lecture flow where we will discuss five content: introductions of trusses, applications, types of trusses, classification of a truss, and analysis of a truss. So, let we explain introduction of trusses. So, trusses or frame structure are made of angle channels. It is normally used to support structure supporting load. The structure may be made up several bar riveted, welded to one another is called frame structure, and the bar used in frame structure consists of angle section, I section, T section, and commonly terms as a member. In some structure, member may be joined by pin or bolt and nut to facilitate their dismantling. So, if we fully understand the concepts of truss, so truss is a structure made up different or several straight member riveted, welded or bolted together in a form of network of triangle. For the calculation purpose, the joint of the truss is to be hinged or pin jointed. Okay. Now, application of the frame structure or truss is bridge truss, workshop roof, TV towers, cellular phone towers, electricity transmission tower. Now here we can see here application of truss, bridge truss, workshop roof, TV tower and cell phone tower, electricity transmission tower. These are the application of truss or frame structure. Now, if we just talk about types of a truss, so we have three types of truss: plain truss, rigid truss, simple truss. So we will define one by one. If all member of the truss essentially lie in a single plane, then it is called plain truss. Okay. If all truss doesn't collapse when loaded, it is called rigid truss. So, the term of rigid truss is that there is deformation between the member is negligible in case of rigid truss. And simple truss, the basic element of a plain truss is a triangle structure built from the basic triangle by adding different member is called simple truss. Okay. So, plain truss lie in a single plane. We can see here, there are all member essentially lie in a single plane. Now, rigid truss, to prevent collapse, the form of the truss must be rigid. For example, in the following figure, we are adding one extra member AC, right, to stabilize the truss. And simple truss, basic element of a plain truss is triangle, and structural built from a basic triangle are known as simple truss. Truss member equals to force member. So there are some member, right, like this. Now if we just talk about classification of a truss, a truss can be classified by two type, perfect truss and imperfect truss. Okay. Now, if you just talk about perfect truss, so in perfect truss, member is just sufficient to keep it in equilibrium when loaded without any change its shape. If you just simply define perfect truss are kinds of a truss where follow the equation of n equal to 2j minus 3, where n is a number of member, j means number of joints, right? And value of 3, it is a totally value of reaction ki how many reactions are applied to entire truss. So this is a perfect truss and this is imperfect truss. Imperfect truss may be sub-classified deficient truss and redundant truss. So if you just talk about imperfect truss, so imperfect truss, it doesn't follow the equation n equal to 2j minus 3. That means number of member greater or larger than 2j minus 3. So this kinds of truss is not imperfect. So perfect truss capable of bearing load and also satisfy the condition as follows. So m number of member, j means number of joints, and 3 means how many number of reactions are acting on entire truss. So now this is imperfect truss, which is not capable of taking loads condition, where m equal to 2j minus 3 is not satisfied, right? So they have two subcategory, deficient truss, in which m is less than 2j minus 3, and here redundant truss, in which m is greater than 2j minus 3, means number of member is less than equation of 2j minus 3, and in redundant truss, where m is greater than 2j minus 3. Now, where we can see there are some figure for perfect frame, deficient or unstable frame, or redundant frame. Frame sometimes we can call as a truss. So perfect truss, deficient truss, or redundant truss. So perfect truss, simplest example of perfect truss is a basic triangle. So there are two triangles, right? So in this figure we are looking here 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 member, and number of joints 1, 2, 3, and 4. And if you just talk about total reactions, so how many reactions are here, because here is hinge joint, right? So hinge joint, there are two reaction, one reaction is horizontal and other reaction is upward vertical reaction, but in case of roller reaction only a vertical reaction, right? So 3 means horizontal, vertical, and vertical. So there are 3 reactions. So formula equal to m equal to 2j minus 3. So m is the number of members. So if we are putting value of m here in m, and 2 into j, j means 4, 2 4 is 8, 8 minus 3 means 5. So member 5 and 2j minus 3, 5. So total value LHS equal to RHS, that means we can say ki truss is a perfect truss. Now second figure, you are looking, there are 4 member, 1, 2, 3 and 4, attached with 2 support reaction, one is hinge, other is vertical. So total reaction is 3 due to horizontal reaction and vertical reaction, and in roller reaction only vertical reaction. So if you are putting value of 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 member and joints 1, 2, 3 and 4. So m, value of m, number of member 4, or equals to 2j minus 3. So 2 into 4, 2 4 is 8 minus 3. So 4 is less than 5. That means these types of truss or frame is unstable or deficient truss. And next figure is here. There are 6 member, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, and joints is 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So there are 2 support, hinge support and roller support. So in hinge support, there are 2 reaction, horizontal reaction, vertical reaction, or in this roller support only vertical reaction. So value is 3, right? So total number of members 6, and number of joints is 4 in this truss. So m is greater than 2j minus 3, right? If you are putting all the value in this equation, m equal to 2j minus 3, so m is number of members, 6 is greater, because 2 into j, 2 into 4 means 8, 8 minus 3, 5, and number of, sorry, 2 into 6, total member of truss is 6, and j, joint value is 4, so 2 into 4, 8 minus 3, 5, and members, how many members are here? 6, so 6 is greater than 5, so these types of truss is redundant truss. Now, we talk about analysis of a truss. So, there are two methods, method of joint and method of sect. Okay, now if you just talk about method of joint, this method is useful to finding the forces in all member of truss, right? And if you just talk about method of section, and this method is particularly used when magnitude and nature of forces in few members are required to be find out. So our lecture of truss is over now. So kindly subscribe my YouTube channel.